Hello, Super Mobile fans. Happy New Month. Wishing you lots of success as you hustle this month. Thanks for your support towards this channel. I appreciate you all. The Oppo Nigerian team reached out to me with the Oppo A5s smartphone, and it has been my daily driver for 2 weeks now. Here's my honest opinion about this device. Kindly sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. I was given the 4GB RAM variant with 64GB internal memory, which cost about 70,000 naira. There's also a 3GB RAM version for 54,000 naira. Tearing the nylon off and opening the box, we are greeted with an envelope containing the SIM injector pin, user manuals, and finally the soft silicone case which feels strong and high quality. Next is the smartphone which we will check out later. Going further, there's a wall charger which looks solid and rugged. This is a 10-watt charger, so no fast charging. Then we have the micro USB cable. That's all in the box. Sadly, there's no earphone. Taking the plastic off the phone, we can see the smooth glazing gold plastic back. There is a speaker, micro USB, microphone, and headphone jack. The right has only the power button and nothing at the top side. The left has the volume rockers and the dual SIM slot with a dedicated SD card slot. The back houses the dual rear cameras with single LED flash, the fingerprint scanner, and the Oppo branding. I love the way the phone fits tightly in the silicone case, and the silicone case extends above the screen for extra screen protection during sudden falls. Setting up for the first time, you are greeted with the ColorOS 5.2 version, and few days later I received an OTA update for a July 2019 Android security patch. This means Oppo cares about software updates. This is a 6.2 inches vibrant display with a screen resolution of 720p HD+, and it has a Corning Gorilla Glass 3 protection. It also comes with a pre-applied plastic screen protector for additional security. Unfortunately, you cannot hide the water drop notch, so this phone is strictly for notch lovers. There's no font styles, which could be a deal breaker, but at least you can change the screen color temperature. You can also choose how each apps interact with the water drop notch. The Oppo A5s also has a night shield mode, also referred to as eye care, but Oppo went further to add some effects like color, black and white, and comfortable nighttime reading, which is my favorite because it is the safest solution to eye care and longer battery life. There's no LED notification light, but the screen lights up when a notification comes in. Here's how the speaker sounds like. Although the cameras are not really the popular feature of the Oppo A5s, but its 30 megapixel camera still manages to surprisingly produce some decent, sharp, and well detailed looking photos. Here are some of my best shots. Let me know what you think about the camera quality.
The Oppo
Oppo A5s is powered by the 9-month-old Helio P35 octa-core chipset, clocked at 2.3 GHz. For those of you that want to know, the Helio P35 is similar to the Snapdragon 630. However, the Helio P35 offers better performance and longer battery life because it is a 12-nanometer chipset as against the Snapdragon's slower 14-nanometer design. My usage with it has been smooth and fast. There has been no disturbing lags or bugs. Switching between apps is smooth. It handles multitasking quite well, as it can retain up to 20 apps at once in the background for a reasonable amount of time. RAM management is good thanks to the 4GB RAM size, and I always get about 2GB RAM left after opening most social media apps and 1GB RAM left after adding a heavy game to the background. Here is the Antutu and Geekbench 4 benchmark scores. I would have loved to see at least a 100,000 score, but the Geekbench score looks good. Overall, I can say that the software optimization between the ColorOS 5.2 and the Android 9 Pie is good. The game space technology allows the Oppo A5s to play games with a better CPU performance and less distraction from notifications. Here are some 2D games I played, and it handled them well with no lags. I also played a 3G PUBG game, but it could only play with low and medium graphics settings. You will sometimes notice the lags, but having a lower 720p HD plus screen resolution is an added advantage. Although I did notice some heat at the back, but not too alarming. Generally, from information online, the Helio P35 processor can play the Alpha 9 well, but its GPU is not powerful for the PES 2019 game, so take note. One of the popular features of the Oppo A5s is its big 4220mAh battery size, which I believe will make many people to desire the Oppo A5s in Africa. The big battery is supported with some power saving options that you can customize based on your preferences. You are also provided with 3 days battery usage analysis, which allows you to compare your daily battery usage to help you manage your usage time. The sleeping mode smartly adjusts the CPU performance to save battery life when the phone is in idle state. Finally, the one-tap mode turns off power draining apps, location services, and disables background apps. My experience with the battery performance is quite good. I did a discharge test, which I set the display brightness level to 50%. I also browsed the internet with 4G network turned on, and I was able to get a screen on time of about 6 hours, which is good. Here is the result of my movie battery test, which means on the average, you can have up to 22 hours movie watch time with full battery. The last battery test I did was while playing the heavy PUBG game. With 85% screen brightness level, 4G network turned on, and maximum speaker volume, I was able to get about 7% battery drop for 21 minutes gameplay, which means you can play between 5 to 7 hours on full battery. It takes about 2 hours 15 minutes to charge the 4230mAh battery, which is quite slow in 2019 when we are already getting used to fast charging. The Oppo A5s comes with Android 8.1 Oreo software, which could be a deal breaker for some people. But the custom ColorOS 5.2 UI has some interesting features that might convince you to still buy it. Number 1 is extra security. Firstly, let me show you the unlock speed of both the fingerprint sensor and face unlock security. Both are quite fast, but I still prefer the fingerprint unlock, which is more secure, even though I find the face unlock to be more convenient. The face unlock also uses the screen flash to compensate for darker environment, and you also have the option to unlock directly into the home screen or swiping up first after unlock. For extra security, you also have the option where the phone will refuse to unlock with your eyes closed, and this means no one can unlock your phone with your face when you are asleep. Unlike the usual method of resetting your lock screen password with your fingerprint, the Oppo A5s gives you an extra layer of security, in which the Oppo team sends you a password reset code through your email address, which can save you the trouble of performing a factory data reset, especially if you don't have a fingerprint already enrolled. Oppo also went the extra mile in giving the Oppo A5s a top-level security called the Privacy Passcode, which stores your password in hardware chip using the Trusted Execution Environment (TEE), which Oppo claims protects your information from theft or online hackers. You can set a security question just like you do while setting up your email address. This can be used to lock your apps and also your private safe. The Oppo A5s comes with a private safe app where you can hide files like photos, music, or any other information. There's also the Oppo Secure Keyboard, which claims to protect your online password from fraudsters. Number 2, friendly data saver. It automatically turns off the data connection when the preset limit is exceeded after you fail to respond to the reminder. You can also choose which apps is allowed to use the Wi-Fi or mobile data, or ban apps from any network. At the bottom of the notification bar, you can monitor your daily and monthly data usage. You can also monitor the data usage of your hotspot connection. This is a very useful information that will save you lots of data, especially from friends who want to take unfair advantage of your shared hotspot data. Number 3. Smart and convenience. You can remap the power button to wake the Google Assistant by pressing and holding for a short time. This is quite convenient compared to saying, OK Google, nice one Oppo. Another unique feature of the Oppo A5s is its numerous navigation gestures. You can hide the key navigation buttons to have more screen estate. It has up to 4 gesture navigations, which gives you more convenience, especially with the guide bar. Number 3 is the one you are used to, while number 4 has back at the left. Number 2 would have been my favorite because you can navigate from any part of the bottom, but you will have to give up the back navigation, which is weird. I hope they fix this in software update. The mistouch prevention helps to prevent accidental gestures, but this might reduce the gestures sensitivity, but it's a good addition. The assistive board also has a new gesture touch which you can customize, and this is cool, and you can choose to hide it in full screen mode. It has a smart sidebar that surprisingly gives you access to some floating apps, which is a good form of multitasking, especially when you need to quickly reply a message without interrupting your gameplay, movie, or browsing. This is very cool. Nice job, Oppo. It also has some special screen off gestures that gives you control over your music playback, allows you to call your favorite contact or start an app or just unlock the phone. Here's a sample of the music gesture control. The smart call settings allows you to automatically make a call, answer a call, and switch from speaker to receiver when you hold the phone near your ear. This is dope. There's also raise to wake screen and three finger screenshot, which gives you access to the long screenshot mode. There's a smart driving mode that activates the do not disturb mode for safer driving experience. The smart assistants give you access to weather forecast, step tracker, and some other recent apps. It has a kit space or guest mode where you can choose which apps you want to be accessed and for how long you want the guest or kid to have access to your phone. This is cool. The quiet time settings put the phone in silent mode, but the special thing about it is that you can choose to allow notifications or messages or calls from special friends, which is cool. There's also app cloning, which works well, and you can rename the cloned app. Would like to mention that it supports OTG connection and it can play 4K videos without frame drops. This is surprising for a 720p screen. There are some other cool features and customizations, but I can't tell you guys because I want to make this video as short as possible. Thanks for watching to this point. In conclusion, the Oppo A5s is a good smartphone and I recommend it if you don't mind the older Android 8.1 Oreo system. And on the bright side, you have lots of customizations to play with. Looking at the 70,000 naira price, it seems a little big when considering the competition, but I guess it costs more to input all these cool customizations I talked about. And it's the cheapest smartphone you can get that comes with the MediaTek Helio P35 processor. The choice is yours. Let me know what you think about the Oppo A5s. Thanks for watching. Talk to you in my next video. Remain humble. Bye.
Oppo.